of God's providence and how God works different areas at the same time. And so God was already working on Cornelius, and he was working on Peter at the same time, and they both had different things that they needed to do. He told Cornelius to send for Peter, and he told Peter that there were going to be some men that were going to come send for you. I'm about to get there here to say it. And so verse number 18, he called and asked Simon, where was Simon? And while Peter thought of a vision, the Spirit said unto him, behold, three men are looking for him. He says, I want you to go down, and I don't want you to doubt anything, because these are going to be three Gentiles coming for you. And I don't want you to doubt it, because it might seem a little bit unusual. Let me tell you something. God is at work. The rules are involved when God is at work. And if God tells you to do it, the rules go out the window. Matter of fact, he was the one who made the rules in the first place. And so I have to clear it up, Peter, that I have sent these men with there because I know you wouldn't even go talk to them if I didn't clear it up with them. And so Peter went down to the men, and he says, I am who you sent. Now here's the beauty of this story, that Peter didn't even know why they were coming. Says, I'm the one who, I'm Simon Peter. Who are you looking for? Why are you looking for? And they said, Cornelius, a centurion. I believe Peter still didn't understand what it was at this point. But he's a just man, one that feared God, a good report among the nations of Jews. He was warned of God by a holy angel to send for thee into this house to hear words from thee. This is the purpose. Why are you down here in Joppa? Why are you God spoke to Cornelius. We work for Cornelius. I guard Cornelius. God sent us from Cornelius. All right, he told us to come down here to get you that we might hear chapter 11, the Bible says that Peter took six brothers with him. And I don't blame Peter to take his entourage. I don't know what's going down in Caesarea. I don't know what Cornelius has for me. They might try to trap me. I got to take six of my boys, and I'm paraphrasing with me, to go down here with me. So even though Peter responded to the vision, Peter wasn't done. Don't ever let nobody call you to a place without some backup. I hate watching shows and the cop thinks he's a super cop. I'm going to go down here and I'm going to go try that. And then he gets out there and he has no backup. That's not even part of our sermon. So but we have to understand, let's stop right here, to understand that it was prophesied in Scripture, all right, that the Gentiles had to be brought in. All right? And the only way that they were going to be brought in was through Christ. All right?
Me
die on the cross. You know that I got up there and about verse number 1. We see this also in prophecy. What's the Bible say?
Arise.
All right.
Shine.
All right.
The light has come.
All right.
And the glory of the Lord has risen upon thee.
All right. Keep reading.
And behold, the darkness shall cover the earth in gross darkness and evil.
All right.
But the Lord shall arise upon thee, and his glory shall be seen upon thee.
All right. Verse number 3.
And the Gentiles shall come to thy light.
Denying preacher to
Because I'm not even supposed to keep keep company with you. Alright? He says, I should not call, but the Lord showed me something. Yeah. See, God is working on me. See, when God shows you something, brothers and sisters, you got to listen to what God is trying to show you. Because God is trying to show you something for a reason. And when God instructs you, you ought to do what God instructs you to do. He says, but God has shown me to call any man. Now watch this. At first, when Peter saw the vision, he thought he was talking about food. I love how the Lord works. It amazing. But Peter says, now God showed me to call. Don't call any man. Yeah. When you look back up, the Bible never said any man. Well, but now Peter, once he got there, he started to get the point of the situation. All right? Now, and the Bible says, in verse number there, it says, therefore I came with you without gainsaying, without prophecy, as soon as I was sent for. And I asked, therefore, what intent did have you sent for? Cornelius said, okay, let me tell you what happened to me. Make a long story short, 4 days ago, I was fasting at night down at my house, and a man stood in my door. And he said, Cornelius, your prayers have been heard, your alms have gone up as remembrance in the sight of God. He says, send therefore to Joppa and call Peter. And he says, and when he comes, he will speak unto you. And immediately, I know you like talking about coming, but immediately, when God speaks, he did what he was supposed to do. Amen. At his word. Remember, nevertheless, at that word, immediately, he says, I sent to you. And he says, you've done well to come. I imagine Cornelius didn't know whether or not Peter would come. But it's remarkable what can happen when two men start listening to God. That's not even in my sermon. Now, he says, now therefore, we're all here. And we're present before God. And he says, here's the kicker. We've come to hear the things that are commanded.
Yes, sir.
Whatever you tell us, Peter, am I painting a picture for somebody? And I'm trying to build this up so we can get that Peter has something to say. We haven't heard it yet, but whatever you've come to tell us, we know that it was commanded.
Right.
It was imperative. It was necessary. In other words, God has commanded you to tell us something. And see, here's the thing. People like to say, God used to say, but the Lord wouldn't have had all this stuff happen for no reason. It's a message. It's a message to all of us. It's a message to all the good men, so-called good men in the house, that have not obeyed the Lord completely.
All right?
Bible says, Peter getting off his mouth, and I love this. Peter says, I perceive that God is no respecter of persons. But in every nation, men that fear him and work in righteousness accepted with him. Alright? So he said, you are accepted with God. You were accepted with God. And we heard your prayers. God remembered that you're praying. But there's something else you got to do. Alright? The word which God sent unto the children of Israel, preaching peace, not Jesus Christ, he is Lord of all.
Amen.
But Peter had to say that he's the Lord of all, not just the Jews, but to the Gentiles.
So,
to you too. Alright? That word I say, which you have published throughout all Judea, and begins from Galilee after the baptism which John preached. Alright, and to sum this up, what was Peter's sermon? You know, we ought to be able to preach this sermon every week, and it ought to still work. And sometimes we in the church, we don't even like to hear this. We just talk about the church. But it still works. If it worked for Cornelius, it worked for us today. If it worked for the household of Lydia, it'll work today. If it worked for Paul and 3,000 at Pentecost, it'll still work today. The Bible says, he says, that word which I say, it was published by Jesus. Okay, God these things. This had to be the Son of God. And he says, and what they did is they hung him out on a tree. And they hung him out on a tree. He bled out of the tree. They nailed him in his hands. They nailed him in his feet. And they mocked him. And they spit on him. And they put a crown of thorns upon his head. And he bled out on Calvary for you and I. And they hung our saints on the tree. And I know you're a good man anymore, Jesus. And I know you pray to God. But there's something else that I've got to tell you. Because you can't get to God without getting to Jesus. And I know you think you know God. Because first you got to hear about Jesus.